What up? It's the Trooper. Yo, today is Saturday. Gotta pay the bills today. You know, it's July 2nd. It's rent time. Also pay the car payment, all that shit. You know what I mean? Why is there so much dust on the lens of my new camera? Oh boy, so yeah, gonna go play poker at the Golden Nugget as soon as I'm done with this. I'm doing everything right here, right downtown. All the shits that I gotta do, I'm doing them right here downtown. What is this? I don't know what. Oh shit, I'm dizzy. First thing I gotta do is hit up the ATM. And you know me, I love hitting up the ATM. But why? Because I get to drive the wrong way into the bank. And people go, oh, Trooper, why are you driving the wrong way? Back up, back up, back. Bitch, it will be helpful if you put it in drive. Road close to what? Damn. That's fucking me up right there. Road closed. So now I gotta go get a money order for the rent. You know I don't write checks. Who the hell writes checks? You know when the last time I had a damn check was? It's been forever. I usually try to go to Check City and get free money order, but there's no Check City anywhere close to here. So we're just gonna have to pay the little terrible's gas station and a little few cents, whatever it is. Now, I just gotta swing through a mailbox, drop a little something in, and then we're off to the Golden Nugget. Let's do this. Box check. Look, donut bar. I don't want a donut right now, and I don't want to leave them in the car in this blazing heat, and I don't want to go back home to Desert Manor right now, or I would go get one of those damn lemon pistachios. Gah, best donut I ever tasted in my whole life. Yo, the little ticket shit was broken. It didn't give me a ticket when I pulled into the parking garage. That's gonna present a problem later. But I guess I'll go down there to the booth and ask the lady where you exit and be like, yo, the shit's broken. What's up with that? Is the thing broken? It didn't give me a ticket. So when I leave in 4 hours, I'll be all right? Okay, thank you. She said I'm gonna be all right. Should I take a word? I guess I have to. What kind of tree is that? That's a weird tree.
All right.
head over to the Golden Nugget, hit Starbucks, get a sandwich and a coffee. I'm already on the list. Call them, of course. Always.
To the Batmobile.
Except when I forget. Which isn't that often. So I found this phone on the Starbucks patio. It's like a little thing or whatever. Somebody just dropped it, I guess. But I put it on my table and waited, you know, while I ate my sandwich. Just, oh, it's vibrating. Hold on, let me see.
Hello?
No, no, I found this phone. All right, so they don't speak English. Her name was Carlita. So where the hell is the security desk in the Golden Nugget? I don't even know if there is one. I'm trying to find a security guy to turn it in. All right, I turned the phone into the first security guy I found. Now we're gonna go play poker. I better be on the damn list. I called. Sometimes shit just falls through the cracks here at the Golden Nugget poker room. I forgot my damn water. That bothers me. Now I gotta tip a dollar for a shitty little bottle of water when I could have had my much larger 10 cent water. Story, or I guess what prompted the story. Let's start off with that. The guy said, try to bluff me? Like he's some kind of badass because of some call that he made. So I'm up 200. The guy on my left raised a couple of hands pre-flop. So I limped under the gun with ace queen. He raised a 12. This is like the second or third hand, probably the third hand in a row that he's raised. And he had about 200. Maybe a little more, 230. I was trying to decide if I wanted to raise or just call, you know, and play the flop. So I just called. Three small cards, I check, he bet 17, I called. Turn is another small card. It was like 8-7-4 deuce at this point. I checked and he checked. River was a jack. My plan was to check raise the river. I had a feeling he might have ace king, maybe something, you know, king queen or whatever. I checked and he bet, and the way he did it and the way he stacked the chips up or whatever, and he bet like more than the pot. He bet like $75. So as soon as his hand came off the money, I just said all in and pushed 200 out. This guy thought for a month, and he was just thinking, and he was so stressed over it. It was $100 more for him to call or something like that. Finally, he called. He had ace jack. Worst river ever, I guess, for me to check raise. But he was like, yeah, try to bluff me. And it was funny because then he sort of like got cocky about his call. And then he contradicted himself like five times after that, saying that he wasn't sure and he had to think about it. He also said it was a good bet, but then he also said he was never folding. So it's like, come on, man. Were you thinking about folding or never thinking about folding? So anyway, it was just funny. But it's kind of a shitty, try to bluff me? You can't bluff me type of shit. I'm gonna bust his ass is what I'm gonna do. Is that not the saddest sight you've ever seen? It's been like that for like 2 hours. Damn. Time to get another one. What the fuck? There's a huge line. I'm not waiting in line. I'm gonna do without. Corporate Starbucks stores are generally really fast. Casino Starbucks are usually slow as shit. Somebody wanna explain to me why that is? Yo, I just wanna make a point about James Woods. The fact that I saw him in the laundromat yesterday, And I was joking about trying to get him in the vlog or whatever. Let me tell you why I did it. When he was at my table last year, whenever someone would mention something to him, when someone said something about him being an actor or a movie star or whatever, he shied away from it. It became really clear really quickly to me that he just wanted to blend in and be a poker player. I guess basically what I'm saying is he didn't want necessarily to be called out. You know what I mean? And I don't know, I just thought if I got out and said something to him that, you know, he would assume and know that I was referring to the acting, which is probably not true, especially since we did play at the same table last year and he commented about my villain hat, commented that he liked the villain hat. And, you know, he got it, he understood what it meant. And I don't know, I probably could have got out and said that to him and I'm sure he would have been in the vlog. Yes, I probably dropped the ball by not doing it, but I'm just trying to explain to you what my reasoning for not doing it was. I didn't want to bug the guy. To my pleasant surprise, this location is open right now. I guess it's because it's Saturday. Oh shit, we got one laid out. What happened? Ladies. Super hot blackjack dealers. Scantily clad, might I add? It rhymes? No? I know. Stupid. Winning 103 today, 103, and yeah, I'm out of time, you know, gotta go deal the link. Yo, I wish I had time and that the donut bar was open. I don't even know if they're open. What time do they close? I think they close at like 5 or something, but I wish they were open and I wish I had time to go get those lemon pistachio donuts. Those are the best damn donuts I ever ate in my whole life. What? Why am I rapping the shit that don't even rhyme or sound like rap? I'm not a fucking rapper, okay? Now remember, if you like the videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos. Leave a comment below because I read them all. And yo, I'll see you next time. Yo, by the way, JD, thank you. Unnecessary, but thank you. Until the wife, I said, na 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 na.